All right, so in this video, I'm gonna show you how to make an autocomplete list similar to what I have here. So just to give you an example, if I go here and start typing, for example, olive, see, as soon as I do that, it gives me all possibilities for olive oil from here. And you could just pick one by using your arrow keys or with your mouse and select one of those. Or I can just go and type, see, oranges, and the list shows up. But what's also interesting about what I'm showing you here is that we can also do an option that doesn't exist. So I can choose one of these available values, but I could also just do a new option like that. And then when I do a new option like that, the next time when I type oranges, see, that will show up in this new autocomplete option list as one of the options. Now, Google Sheets has built-in autocomplete that works kind of the same, but it's not the same. So just to give you an example, so if I go here and type the first option, and then if I go right below this and type F, see, it automatically suggests this option to complete. So if I had another option here, then again, if I type F, it will give me the autocomplete for the first one. And if I type O, it will give me the autocomplete for the second one, which is kind of nice. The problem with this autocomplete is that as soon as you start having more options, so for example, now I have two options for olive oil. Now if I type O, I don't get those autocomplete options. So I have to type enough for it to figure out which option to narrow down to. So at least I have to get to this point, E or this O, to be able to autocomplete, which is really annoying when you start dealing with lists that are a little larger than just a few options. So to do this, we need to learn a couple of things. So the first thing is going to be data validation and dropdown lists. So if we go to data validation, there's an option to do list from a range. So to give you an example, if I just delete all of these and go here and do something like this, select this area, go to data validation, and then I can do list from a range and select this range over here as the range I want to basically use for autocomplete. And if I hit OK and I hit save here, this list will let me now type one of those items from the other list, see, like this, and it will give me this autocomplete, and I can actually type that. And then if I try to do something different, something like that, it will actually let me do that, but I'm gonna get this red warning. And the reason I'm getting that warning, well, because we have data validation, but it's still gonna allow me to place that in, because when I was doing this data validation, instead of doing reject input, I selected show warning option, right? So it will still let me type something else. But the problem is, if I go here and type olive oil, this new option is not gonna be available in this list. So basically, we need to make sure that the same list we type is the list that's being used to do the validation itself. So now let's try to get to this. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna go ahead and create a new worksheet to start from scratch. And I'm just gonna call this my list. And again, what we need here, we need the list that we type to be used as the list for autocomplete. So let me just put a few options here. So that's a good start here. So now I want this list to be used for validation. Let's actually add a new line here and just call this product, just to have a column name to make this look pretty. So at this point, I basically want to keep doing this validation in this rows below, and I'm just gonna highlight starting from this first product, going down. Basically, you would just scroll down as long as you think you're gonna need this validation to keep going. I'm just gonna keep this simple, just 17 lines. And if I go to data and data validation, I want to do list from a range, and the range I want to use here should be the same range that I'm trying to do validation for. Because as I start typing new items here, those should be the ones that show up in the list as well. So if I press OK on this, see I have the same range here and here. And if I do save, see I get this error and it says that the selected ranges cannot intersect. So we can't have this intersect with this. So what we're gonna do to make this happen, we're gonna trick our spreadsheet. So I'm gonna cancel this. And what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna add another worksheet here. I'm gonna call it options, or really anything you wanna call this. And what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna make a copy of whatever is in here to go in this list. So depending on how long this is, that's exactly how long I need that copy to be here. So right now I'm showing you an example with 17 lines, but you're gonna do this for as long as you need this, right? If you need this longer, just go 1,000 lines or whatever it needs to be. So I'm gonna go to options and start from the same row, row 2, and do equals, open a curly bracket like this, go to my list, this worksheet where everything is gonna be typed, and highlight everything starting from line 17 up to that second row. So basically this entire range where the validation is actually going to occur. I'm gonna close curly bracket and hit enter. And what that's gonna do, it's just gonna make a copy of our list over here. So basically now if I go to this list and I type a new item, and as soon as I hit enter, if I go to options, you'll see that pops up here too, because we're making a copy here of the same range we have in this particular list. Now, once I did this, then I'm gonna go ahead and select the same range on this spreadsheet where the input is gonna go from line 2 up to 17 in this case. I'm gonna go to data and do data validation. And then when it's asking for a list as a range, I'm gonna click on this little select the range button and click inside of this, go to options worksheet and select that same range from this options. And by doing this, I'm basically tricking it into thinking that my ranges don't really interfere with each other. So if I press OK, it's gonna pick that options same range from options. This is the same range from my list. And if I press save, now I should have my data validation. Now my data validation is not happening in options, it's happening in my list. So if I go here, you'll see the dropdowns now are showing up based on what's in this options list. So at this point, if I just go here and start typing, see that options now shows up in this list. And if I do oranges, see options show up and I can select one of those, but I can also now type something new. So I can go ahead and do something like oranges, organic or something, it doesn't really matter. And as soon as I do that, see, I don't get that red showing up here because we really get that item as soon as we type in our options list already right here. And that's the list that's being used for validation, which means now if I go and type oranges in the next line, see that option shows up right away as one of the possibilities. And then I can just keep adding more items here. Something like that. And now all those options should show up as I start typing apples again. See, everything I have in the list is gonna show up in the same autocomplete list. So finally, if you don't want to look at this options tab, that's our helper to kind of make this whole thing happen, you can just go ahead and right click on this and hide that worksheet to get it out of the way. And then it's still gonna work the same way. All of these are showing up, so it just works fine. And that should do it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and I'll see you in the next one.